today. From AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas, it's week 4 of the NFL on EA Sports. See Dak Prescott and the Dallas Cowboys taking on Mac Jones and the New England Patriots.
Just a gorgeous fall afternoon in the heart of Texas. No weather to speak of. Sun out, roof open. Yes, yes, and yes. A great day for football at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Obviously, they do everything big here in Dallas, and the introduction of the Cowboys, no exception. They're set for football in Big D, as their guys will do battle with the New England Patriots. Hello again, everyone. I'm Brandon Gunn, joined as always by Charles Davis. And Charles, you take a look at this Cowboy team entering play. They've got to be pleased with the start to this season. Obviously, a perfect 3-0.
Three good quality wins, too. It's got people in the locker room excited. They're thinking that this could be their year.
On the other side of the field for the visiting Patriots, they, too, were winners last time out. So something's got to give here.
And I love it when both teams come in off of wins. Great mindsets, and it usually leads to a really well-played game.
It's 3-0 versus 2-1, a good early season battle as we're underway in week 4. Taken in at the 3. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. Time for Dak Prescott and the Dallas offense to go to work. Prescott, of course, the former fourth-round pick in 2016 out of Mississippi State.
It's been a lot of fun watching him advance in his career. Many people question his ability to throw the football coming out of Mississippi State. He's conclusively answered that question. In addition, a very strong runner and an even better leader.
Prescott looks to throw on first. That's complete to the tight end Sample. And they're able to get this one across the 35. These are his numbers from last week's contest. 5 catches, 53 yards.
And I'd certainly expect them to use him quite a bit because he runs excellent routes, has good hands, and knows how to get open.
Dak dropping this one off for Zeke. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
I like it, I like it, I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game. And you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so. It gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it. It really gets them amped up as they go forward.
So into Pat's territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 49-yard line. They keep on the ground with Elliott. And he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much as he's down to the 48. Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run. A give to Elliott. And they'll get this just to the 47, 1 yard gain.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout. And that means your offense has to keep pace.
So on 4th down, on is the punter, Pat O'Donnell, to kick it away. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. With a former member of the Crimson Tide, Damian Harris. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. He was well over 100 yards last week. He told us this week, a little ambitious, said he wants to hit that 200 mark. We'll see.
Makes sense, though, doesn't it? Have we ever run into a running back that had a great game the week before that didn't think that's just going to naturally continue? Just make sure you feed me the football. And that's what they're all about. Continuity, rhythm, number of carries. Just keep giving it to him.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. On the give, this is Harris. As he's got this down inside the 40 to the 39. A look at the numbers for Harris in last week's game. Two trips to the end zone and well past 100 yards.
And going back and watching the film, we saw every kind of run from him, didn't we? We saw some power, we saw finesse, we saw speed, and what I love the most, he finished each and every run.
You were telling me this yesterday. That's exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. We're scoreless after one. Throwing, Jones. He finds Aguilar over the middle. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed. Because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked up by Trayvon Diggs. And the Cowboys are going to have it here as they'll start at their own 7. Charles, not only is that an interception, it's one when you were really knocking on the door for a touchdown inside the red zone.
You're actually thinking points. No matter what, at worst, you're thinking kicking a field goal and getting 3. We might look back on this in the second half and say, you remember when they didn't get points on that drive? This could cost them.
Now a throw here to his running back, and they'll get him down up past the 15-yard line.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon, and it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line.
That was good, tough running right up the middle. And if the defense can't penetrate and make him slow his pace or change direction, that's often the end result.
Meanwhile, Dax throw into the hands of Sample. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. The give is to Elliott. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Now they're staring at a 3rd and 8. That last play backwards a yard. Throwing, Prescott. Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line. So this is something we didn't see at all from this offense in the victory last week. That's a turnover. They didn't have any, but giving the ball away here in the opening quarter.
I love the surprise in your voice because it's exactly what you stated. Didn't see it last week, but it's a key to their win. And it'll be a key to this game as well, protecting the football. Didn't get it done there.
48 yards rushing for him now in the ball game. 2 minutes on the clock in what's been a scoreless first half. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line.
They were not fooling around at all, were they? 2nd and short, and they brought out the heavy package. Almost like the super heavy package against that defense, didn't it?
Yeah, I don't think they expected that much beef up. And he's in! Touchdown, Patriots! Damian Harris, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the Patriots, on just 2 plays, have taken the lead. A strong, determined run there, Charles, to get in for 6 points.
This is why it's such a team game, isn't it? And I know that sounds really generic and it sounds almost trite, but the blocks were made up front, offensive line, collective victory at the line of scrimmage and downfield. And how about the finish to the run all the way into the end zone?
They'll try and throw for it. It's caught, and it's 8-0. So they elect to pass there on the two-point try. Sometimes could prove risky there. It worked out.
Yeah, and I love how you bring up that it can prove risky, because if you get it intercepted, they return it. That's 2 points for the defense, but not on that play.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Zeke and the Cowboys ready to begin their next drive. First month of the season, those numbers pretty solid. Does he continue that?
I think so, because when you come out of the gate this strong, that means that you have planned for it and you like the results that you're getting. So I wouldn't have any doubt that the head coach, offensive coordinator, actually called him in and said, look, you're our guy, okay? We're going to continue to stick with this as long as we're winning games. You ready for the challenge? And then they've presented it to the rest of the team. I think we'll see plenty of that as the season moves on.
And I'm sure he said challenge accepted. Now Prescott. Able to hit his target, Lamb. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2. To the air again, Prescott. Out to the left, he's got Sample there. And he gets his down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. Prescott to throw it. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
On 2nd and 10, Prescott. And there is Amari Cooper, his first catch. The Cowboys going to use their 2nd timeout now as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. Prescott on 3rd and 2. He's going to find Gallup here complete. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they get 5 there on 3rd and 2. Prescott yet again. That's caught once again by Gallup. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. The Cowboys signal for their 3rd and final timeout, as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. Looking to throw, Prescott. And they're going to get to him, a sack. Sacked back at the 9-yard line. Another shot from the 9 on 2nd and goal. So at halftime, it's the Patriots with the advantage. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. A lot to get to here as we say goodbye to September and take a look around the NFL here on this first day of October. We'll get started down at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami. And it's the Raiders who have the lead in that one. Aaron Rodgers has thrown a touchdown pass. From there, we'll head up to Indy to check on the Colts at home at Lucas Oil Stadium. And this one going the visitor's way as the Texans have the lead in that one. Deshaun Watson has thrown a touchdown pass. Finally, let's get you to Baltimore. Check on the Ravens at home at M&T Bank Stadium. And it's the visiting Jets who have the lead in that one. Former number two pick Zach Wilson with a couple of touchdown passes. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a defensive struggle. Which offense can break through in the second half? To find out, let's hand it over to our broadcast team of Brandon Gotten and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. So here we go for half number two. The Patriots with the lead, and they will be getting the football. And we will not have a run back here as the second half starts with a touchback. So here are the Patriots to take over. They were winners last week in that game against Kansas City, and they are on top right now as well. They've got it first and 10. They'll start on the ground with Harris, and this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
And some room to run now. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 92 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon. Now a first down carry for Harris. And now they're going to get him down right at the line of scrimmage. Tyquan Lewis makes a stop. Defensively, though, they had a chance there to hit him for a loss. Couldn't get it done.
Looked like someone was able to knife into the backfield, but he wasn't able to get him down. But his compatriots, they were able to grab him at the line of scrimmage and not let him get any further downfield.
Now Jones. He's got it complete to Aguilar. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. A big play there for the Patriots. The defense, they weren't fooled on that post route. They just couldn't make the play.
And the offense definitely tried to fool them because you saw the other route combinations, didn't you? Anything that they were running trying to draw attention away from the deep part of the field, but still had it covered, yet they were able to come up with a nice play.
And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7.
Boy, how about the speed with which this offense can get down the field? It's taking them no time at all to get down here, and now they're set up with a first and goal.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Damian Harris with his second touchdown of the game, number 7 on the year. And the Pats take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. That seemed pretty ideal there for the offense, Charles. You take a little bit of time off the clock here in the third quarter, decent length drive, and you pad your lead as well at the end of it.
And what it does is let you feel like you're in control of this game, even more so than a 2-touchdown lead, right? Because you have taken that time off, as you noted, which means they couldn't get you off the field. You ran your playbook the way you wanted to, and you gave your defense some rest. What a big-time drive in that situation.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one. It's through the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Cowboys offense now, they head out for their first possession of the second half. And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go 3 and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors. I like how they worked the tight end on a nice little under route there, and if you're going to give him that much space, he's not even going to catch the football. He's going to run away from you a little bit, and that's exactly what he just did there, picking up extra yardage.
Prescott on first down. On the left side, Gallup's got it. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. Second down at 4. Here's Prescott. He's got a man complete. It's Amari Cooper. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. Okay, so now the question, how did he get that wide open?
Well, we both know that he shouldn't, because from the time they handed out scouting reports before this game, he was circled, starred, everything. Find him, cover him. But sometimes you can scheme a guy open. You put the receivers in a bunch, maybe you move some motion, maybe you put them on the backside of a formation, and all of a sudden you've got a better matchup. Every now and then, the offensive guys, they figure a way to get him open, even with everyone keeping eyes on him.
And that's certainly a guy they want to keep trying to scheme open. And again, it's Prescott. They'll set up the screen to Elliott. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. He'll lose a yard on the play, so now they need 3 yards on third down. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we play 3 quarters. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Third and short yardage, Prescott. And he's able to hook up with Michael Gallup. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Defensively, you said coming in earlier in the broadcast, the magic number was 20 points for you. That's what you thought they would have to hold this offense to, or less than that. And wow, they've done that in a big way, haven't they?
Not only have they done it, they put themselves in a great position to win this one, because holding them down was paramount. If they could get it done, well, guess what? We see the end result. Right now, they have their eye on victory.
And leading here in the fourth. To throw again on second down. Prescott. That's Gallup on the slant. And the Cowboys are going to be set up with a first and goal here as the tackle made at the 9. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Play action now. Prescott. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. Hammering for the goal line. He loses the football, and it's picked up by the Patriots. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
As they say, this game hasn't exactly been one for the books. I mean, we're into the fourth quarter here, and now this happens, another turnover. Not one that they're going to hold up and say, yeah, this has been a banner day.
Absolutely. Still sitting on 0. 105 yards. He has been tremendous all day long. The last run got 6. Now 2nd and 4. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Harris. And he'll get it up a little shy of the 15. They'll spot him down at the 14-yard line. At carries like that, that's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out. I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now, I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. And his first throw since coming in is incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes. You can read his hands. And you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent. And that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
Stidham from the shotgun. He's got a first down past the 30. He gets it across the 50 and down to the 48. A big play there for the Patriots. So the Patriots with a football as we get you reset. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. It's caught by Aguilar. So fresh out of the two-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. An ideal spot here to get a first down and try to run some more clock, and this is second and less than a yard. Oh, Stidham's actually going to throw it. Completes it to Aguilar. And now we're going to get a timeout defensively. So another stop, 1:50 left in the football game. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Stidham. Over the middle into traffic, and that's complete. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. The Cowboys signal for their third and final timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. Able to stay in bounds, and the clock keeps rolling. This defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot
before. And he's over the line and into the end zone for a Patriots score. Damian Harris, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Patriots are looking to make it 2 straight as they add on to this fourth quarter lead. So it was the passing game that got him down here, but closer to the goal line, it's the running game that gets him home.
Certainly appears that they lulled the defense into thinking that the passing game was going to be it the entire drive. Nice change up there going to the running game to get him over the goal line.
So the Patriot offense stays out there, and they'll line up and go for 2. Stidham going to look to throw for it, and it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by the linebacker, Jalen Smith. He's at the 50, 30, 10, 5, and he takes it all the way back. It's a pick 2, if you will, as that play backfires in a big way. Unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Dallas offense back out onto the field. Remember, they have 1-3 straight, but getting to 4 straight does not appear to be in the cards as they are in a big fourth quarter hole. A first down throw for Prescott. Got his man there, complete to Gallup. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. From the 31, Prescott. Throw right side into the hands of the tight end, Sample. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. On first and 10, Prescott sees Gallup on the sideline, and he's got it. 3 yards the gain there, second down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
They're going to need to get up and set in a hurry. They'll throw again. Prescott. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's going to get this inside the 30. And the offense moving quickly to the line. first down. Prescott, that one complete to Elliott. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. So this will wind up a victory for the New England Patriots. And I'll tell you what, it has not been with a whole lot of frequency over the last couple of decades or so that teams have come into New England and escaped with a victory, but that's what happened here.
It almost doesn't feel real, does it?
We've seen it so few times.
That actually happened, right? We saw it. They came out of there with a win. And on the other side, in that locker room, you know what they're saying? We didn't really lose. Time just ran out on us. That's the attitude they have because they don't see it happen very often. Not even sure how to handle it.
And you see some stunned faces heading for the exits here in New England. So for New England, they're on a nice early roll as they move to 3-1 with a win here.
And they will head home for next week's contest. That is against Washington.
Meanwhile, for Dallas, they're going to fall to 3-1 as they suffer their first loss. And they'll be back home next week for a date with the New York Jets. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, we thank our entire crew. I'm Brandon Gauden. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
tonight. From Gillette Stadium in Foxborough, it's a special primetime edition of the NFL on EA Sports. See Mac Jones and the New England Patriots versus Teddy Bridgewater and the Washington football team.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to Gillette Stadium in Foxborough, Mass. All the success in New England over the last few decades, and this crowd has never been more enthusiastic. A moment ago, the Pats emerged from their locker room. They are set as they'll square off with the Washington football team. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, we look at this Patriots team entering play. They come in feeling good after back-to-back victories.
And if you look back to last week, it was all about their defense. Anytime you hold an NFL team to single digits, that's saying something.
Seems like we were just starting training camp, but here we are in October, and off we go on EA Sports. This is taken just shy of the 10. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. So first and 10 now from the 30. Away, they're going to stack him up right at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the game's first play, and it's second down now. How about this? They'll try the option, left side. And not much of an opening there, as he's only going to get this to about the 32. Only a yard there on the keeper, and that's going to leave him with a third down. To throw is Bridgewater. And oh, that nearly an opening drive INT, but it does fall incomplete. Not the way he wanted to start this ball game, as it brings up fourth down. And now the punter, Tress Way, as he sends this one away. That's fielded at the 8-yard line. So a good punt there, but a nice return of 11 yards. And the Patriots take over. So now we'll get a look at the other offensive unit as they come out for their first possession. They're led by their quarterback from the University of Alabama, Mac Jones. Three tight ends in the ball game here on first and 10. First carry for Damian Harris, the Alabama man. And a really good show of force there as he gets through for four tough yards. Simply not much more you can ask out of your running back. Over 100 yards and the three touchdowns.
And for an old coot like me, I loved it because he did it on the ground. A running back taking control of the game. That's what I like to see.
Hold on, hold on. An old coot?
Coot, C-O-O-T.
All right, I'll look that up later. This Washington defense, Charles, terrific in the victory a week ago.
And what keyed their victory? The pass rush. Got to the quarterback six times for sacks and plenty of other turbulence in the pocket for him as well. Hard to throw the ball downfield when all you're seeing is opposing jerseys come at you.
The connection here with Nelson Aguilar. And they work this well upfield across the 45. So he turned to a trusted, familiar face in that third down situation. It paid off.
Yeah, you go to your veteran receiver in that spot, so you can't underestimate him when he's on the field. Defensively, make sure you know where he is because he understands how to get open.
Looking for Aguilar, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 47. And they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line.
Boy, he had to fit that into a pretty tight window over the middle. And, Charles, I think they were in zone defensively, weren't they?
They certainly were. Nice read on your part. And sometimes The quarterback isn't fooled between zone and man, sometimes just fooled by the type of zone that he sees, because oftentimes those linebackers will vacate and run downfield with receivers. In this case, he played a pure zone and was in the wrong spot for the QB.
To throw again on second down, Bridgewater. He'll get this into the hands of Antonio Gibson. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
Well, they use him a lot out of the backfield. He had 5 catches a week ago, and he makes another catch here for good yardage.
They'll run for the first time with Antonio Gibson. And he'll get this one down to about the 27. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. Bridgewater to throw it. Forced out to his left. And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
Now Bridgewater. And he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a halt. He'll wind up getting right about 4 there on the scramble, and it's 2nd down. Here's Gibson on the read option. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. No score after 1 on EA Sports. Big play coming here. It's 3rd and goal. Here's Bridgewater. In trouble, and he'll go down back at the 12. Dietrich Wise Jr. with a big-time sack on 3rd down. It's a loss of 7. Now on comes the Washington field goal unit. And his kick is right there. It's good, and it's 3-0 Washington. So the turnover leads to points as they add 3 there.
Yeah, what a sequence there, and a nice one for them. They force the interception, put together a little drive, and then come away with 3 points. Nothing to it, partner. Just do it.
And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. Nelson Aguilar and company getting set to go again on offense now. Well, September sure treated him kindly. Now we flip over to October. Any reason to think that those numbers drop, or can he keep the pace up?
Well, he can keep the pace up, but it's going to get a lot more difficult now. To me, it's a lot like baseball. When guys, when they first hit the league, whether it's a pitcher or a hitter, and they go through the league the first time and they're hot, they're going, wow, what a phenom. Then they get tape on them, they get scouting reports, they start to do different things. Let's see if he's going to adapt and expand his game in order to keep up that type of production.
That's a good call, because he's a known entity. See how they defend him going forward. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's 2nd down. Throwing again on 2nd and 10. Jones. Open man is Kendrick Bourne. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, he was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice 1st down.
Back to throw again. Going right side here, and that's complete. Touchdown! His 2nd touchdown on the season, and the Patriots have taken the lead. The call is to go for 1 and kick the extra point. And this is up and good to make it 7-3. Just a 4-play drive that time, and it's finished off by a Pats touchdown. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And Washington going to come back out here to take over offensively. They come off a victory over the weekend, but now the quick turnaround here for this Thursday night game. How does that affect how teams like this approach these short turnarounds?
Well, wins and losses always factor into, you know, how you're getting ready for the next game. But equally as important when you have the short turnaround, what is your injury situation? Are you losing key guys? And if so, how well have the backups prepared for this? Because you don't have much time to get them ready. They have to be ready before this week in order to play well in this game.
To throw on second and 10, Bridgewater. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Flush to his right. And this turns into a nice gain with a slide at the end.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
2 minutes to play in this first half. 7-3, our score. Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. He'll have a look back at our first half, as well as a look ahead to what's coming up. And he goes down. It's a Patriots sack. They'll wind up losing 8 on the sack there, and it's second down. After the sack on first down, Bridgewater. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. Clock running as Washington will try and hurry up. Again, that's Hurst. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. It's another 10 yards on that one and another first down. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense as he'll stop it with exactly a minute to go before halftime. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. From the gun, Bridgewater. It's complete to Brown, right side. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets it down to the 30 there. They'll contain him to just 4, second down. Bridgewater again. This one complete to Curtis Samuel. Now Washington going to use the second of their 3 timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. The red zone now, Bridgewater. He's got his big tight end. That's Hurst. That was the 9th play of the drive, and they pick up 9 yards with it. Throwing again on second down. Bridgewater trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. He's at the 50, the 30, 10, 5, and he takes this one back into the end zone. The Patriot defense has a touchdown. Now remember, this is the number one defense in the National Football League. There's a good example of why.
Shows that they set an aggressive tone, not just stopping the run, not just getting after the quarterback, but the ball's in the air. They treat it like they're the receivers, and they went after that one and took it all the way.
No going for 2. They'll kick the point after. This one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick 6.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he won't quite make it to the 25. Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And with only 9 seconds remaining, well, not much time, we'll see how they play this.
I'll start for offense.
So pin that one on the rookie right tackle.
Remember those days when the right side was simply the run blocking side? Now you're dealing with some of the better pass rushers in the league. It'll make you a little jittery.
And right side, they're going to go option here. And he's going to lose yardage. Not that it matters as the final seconds tick away. So we've reached halftime here at Gillette Stadium with the Patriots on top. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
All right, guys, thanks very much. We'll get back with you shortly. But first, let's take a look at what's coming up this weekend around the NFL. In the 1 o'clock games, the one that catches the eye happens in Big D at AT&T Stadium, a tough test for the Cowboys as they'll square off against the New York Jets. In the late afternoon games, all eyes will be on Las Vegas, a glitzy matchup there, where it'll be the Raiders out on the West Coast. More good stuff in the late afternoon as we'll be watching the game at SoFi Stadium. Well, it will be the Chargers. And lastly, on Monday Night Football, this will be one to tune in for as they've got a good one lined up between the San Francisco 49ers and the LA Rams. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a back-and-forth first half. Who can put it together in the second half? For the answer, we turn it back over to our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. And no run back here as the third quarter will commence with a touchback. So here are the Patriots to take over. They've won two straight, and they lead this one as well as they come up on first and 10. One goes nowhere, losing yardage back at the 22. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
I think it's pretty evident we can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. Now, after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. We'll get a report when we return to Foxborough. Throwing Jones. Throwing into traffic there, and that's complete. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second in just about a few inches here.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
And this is in.
Quarterbacks don't mind throwing into coverage because of the confidence they have in their receivers to come down with the ball. But sometimes you have to be careful you don't get too confident and throw an interception.
Could be four down territory even if they don't get this, but they need just a few inches here on third. And that will be be incomplete.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on third down.
And this will be a long field goal if the skies were clear. But here in the rain and the elements, they'll go for it on fourth. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. Good spot on the field to go for it, kind of no man's land, as they call it, and it worked out.
Yeah, they call it no man's land because your punter is telling you it's too short. I'm just going to punt it into the end zone. Your field goal kicker might give you a little raised eyebrow, might be too far for the field goal, so it gives you a great chance to go for it. Personally, if you have those tendencies to be aggressive as a head coach, you kind of like this spot because it gives you the decision to go ahead and go for it when you want to anyway. And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode.
Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. William Jackson with a pick, and he'll be brought down at his own 10-yard line. So it was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
And right side, they're going to go option here. Showed some strong running, but quickly corralled just beyond the 10-yard line. 2 yards the gain on the keeper, and it's second down. Throwing is Bridgewater. That's the tight end, Hurst, with it. And he gets up near the 25 to about the 24 before going out of bounds. On first and 10, it's Gibson. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
On second and 12, Bridgewater throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Bridgewater. Throw right side, taken in by Gibson. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves him just short for fourth down. Here's Tressway now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. Oh, he'll field it in the end zone. And he couldn't get it to check up. That kicks all the way into the end zone for a touchback. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we've got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you've got three on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one.
And all the way in, touchdown, New England. Damian Harris, an 80-yard touchdown. And the Patriots are able to extend their lead in the final seconds of this third quarter. One play, 80 yards. Pretty easy drive to recap.
It certainly is, but not so easy to execute. Starting on your own 20, you want something to kickstart your drive and get it off to a nice start. They went for the whole thing and got it. That's a great way to send a message to the opposing team.
Footing always a concern, but the extra point's up and good. And the lead is up to 18 now. Kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Takes it at the 7. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. Out there, set ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
One quarter remains here in this Thursday night matchup. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. On second and 15 now, Bridgewater. That one caught by Gibson. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down. Washington on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This time they face a third and two. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. And again, it's Bridgewater. They'll set up the screen for Gibson. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. Clock management, definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
Bridgewater now looking to throw on first. That one is slant to McLaurin. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Throwing, Bridgewater. And he'll complete this to Gibson. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. To the air again with Bridgewater. This is going to be incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Desperation time, fourth down, Bridgewater. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Washington goes for it, but it does not pan out. And the Patriots defense is going to take over on down. The Pats at the line, ready to go. Been a very strong performance for them, really, on both sides of the football. The turnover on downs, the most recent example, and now, obviously, they're in a great spot here.
Yeah, if you're over on the bench right now, you're shaking hands with your teammate, you're hugging him, give him a little dap. Been a big, big performance for them. Now you just don't get careless, take care of the ball on the way out. Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces, and I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Patriots with a football as we get you reset. And no doubt what they're looking to do is just salt away the final couple of minutes and escape with a win. And boy, this burgundy and gold defense charged up now. They stop him behind the line again. 2 yards the loss, and now they go from second and two to a tough third and four. They run again with Harris, and that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
Well, that's not an easy play for a defensive end because most of his responsibility has him getting upfield and working, but how about his vision to see where the play was going, crashed down inside, and tackled him for a loss.
That ball's caught. Aguilar, right side. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44.
And that's a big pickup of a first down. And you know that all week, both sides of the ball, offense and defense, are going through every situation. And in this case, the offensive guys had the right play dialed up because defensively, you work on fourth down situations as well.
And deflating for the defense. They can't get the stop here. Stidham's going to set up to throw this. He's got it complete to Aguilar. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. From the gun, it's Stidham. And this is incomplete. Very lucky to get that one back. That nearly picked. It's second down now. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Stidham going back to the air. Going to throw right side here. Complete. And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 21. And what are the whistles for? Timeout. So they'll stop the clock here in a game that's been decided in the closing seconds. Now Stidham on first down. And they're going to get him. He's sacked back around the 28. Now we'll get whistles, and they've signaled for a timeout. Not sure I see the logic in this, but we'll get a stoppage anyway with 5 seconds remaining. Oh, now look at this. They're lining up to add three more little insult to injury here late in the game. And this will be a 45-yard attempt. And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe. And that will stretch the lead up to 3 touchdowns now. It's a 21-point game.
Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face it, all kickers that you and I know, they want to contribute. They want their opportunity, and he seized his.
And he'll be out of bounds here, a yard shy of the 25 at the 24. Well, in this one, partner, we had some action all the way down to the final whistle there with the late points and then the kickoff to end it.
Yeah, and the best part about it is just seeing how teams battled all the way to the end, you know. Didn't really matter. Scoreboard was pretty well set, but they still competed until the final whistle.
So for the Pats, they boost their record up to a strong 4-1, and they'll get a few days to savor this.
tonight. From Gillette Stadium in Foxborough, it's week 6 of the NFL on EA Sports. Mac Jones and the New England Patriots taking on Trevor Lawrence and the Jacksonville Jaguars.
From a venue that's been sold out since it opened back in 2002, there's a look at the home of the Patriots, Gillette Stadium in Foxborough, Mass. A moment ago, the pride of Massachusetts, the Patriots, introduced to this, as always, sold-out crowd as they get set to go head-to-head with the Jacksonville Jaguars. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, we look at this Patriots team entering play. They come in on a pretty good roll here, winners of 3 straight.
And this coaching staff has to be pleased with how their defense played last week. They held their opponents to 3 points, and that was it. If they get anything comparable to that performance, this one's in the bag.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Jaguars, they were losers their last time out. They're going to try to get back in the win column, but obviously they're going to have to do that in a hostile environment.
And sometimes it actually works to your advantage. Now you've got to band together your team, the us against the world mentality. Let's see if they can use it and get a victory.
To the NFL season, and we are underway on EA Sports. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he returns this to the 22. First and 10, it's Lawrence. A throw complete to the tight end, Tonyan. A good pick up there. 8 yards on the first down completion. They'll run it. This is James Robinson. And this Patriot defense up to the challenge once more as they again stop him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, and now they go from 2nd and 2 to a tough 3rd and 4. Now Lawrence. He's got his man, T.J. Hockenson. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. A gain of 4, not enough. And it looks like punt time on their opening drive as it's 4th down. And here's Gillen on now to punt as he gets this one away. Looking up into the lights, and he muffs it. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble. First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. 3 tight ends are out there. Harris starts to drive on the ground. Breaks a tackle. Now an alley.
Another miss.
Still on his feet. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. Got to give a nod of appreciation to some of those guys up front over on that left side. Several key blocks sprung him.
No appreciation for the guys from the backside that didn't allow any leakage, anybody could run him down from the backside.
They're at the kids' table.
Okay, so front side guys, good, yeah. Backside guys.
Man.
That's what you're supposed to do?
I've had better.
Okay, either way, worked out quite well, didn't it? A nice sizable gain.
A look at the numbers for Harris in last week's game. 7 carries, 87 yards, and a touchdown. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards.
Well, he's the number 2 runner in the league, and you just know the offensive line wants to get him to number 1 because most of the good ball carriers, they take care of their linemen. Could be a gold watch in their future if he becomes the leading rusher.
Now Jones. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on 3rd down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on 3rd down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. So in Jacksonville territory now. Here's a 1st and 10 at the 37-yard line. Back to throw, Jones. Completes it to Aguilar. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line. Boy, the evolution of the game and how these guys in plays like that can get out of the pocket, keep plays alive, it just makes things so much harder for defenses.
It really does, and we're talking about an era in the game where the quarterbacks are the most athletically gifted that we've seen in a bunch. I mean, when you talk about collectively, it's unbelievable. So their ability to move is practiced now. It's not necessarily, oh, he just took off and you guys figure it out. When he takes off, everyone knows where to go now. They know how to run routes, change things, make themselves presentable for the quarterback. It's a lot of time that they put in on it. It's not just your static 1, 2, 3, this is where the ball goes anymore.
They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. We're scoreless after 1. Again, it's Harris. And he is in. Touchdown, New England. Damian Harris hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And they are able to strike first here on their opening drive. But just power football there down near the goal line. Give it to him. He's able to push his way across.
Yeah, they went heavy there. Sometimes you have those big offensive linemen come in after report like they're eligible. But all they're doing is getting a good stance, blocking, and getting their runner across the goal line.
Point after, right down the middle. It's now a 7-0 game. So that drive goes a full 80 yards and 10 plays. And it was Damian Harris who finished things off with a touchdown run. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And he'll just take a seat and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. So time to see Jacksonville again on offense for the 2nd time here in this game.
And on the 1st drive, 3 and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there. 2nd down. Lawrence with the handoff to Robinson. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to 3rd and 10. Here's Lawrence to throw. And a dump off here to Robinson. And he'll only get this to about the 44 as they stop him short of the line to gain. That one good for only six, and it leaves him with a fourth down. Here's Jamie Gillendale as he'll punt it away for the second time. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Pats will be backed up deep to get the drive started as they take over first and 10.
Damian Harris and the Patriot offense ready to take over again.
And we checked the rushing numbers so far here into week six, and the returns have been really good. Now, you're starting to hit that stride middle of the season toward the end. They're certainly hoping they can keep up this production.
They are, because one of the adages in the NFL is that defense travels and defense endures even in bad weather, right? You know what else does? A good running game. And people want that, especially as you head down the stretch. You may play outdoors in some nasty stuff. You're trying to get to the playoffs. This is the time to get it going. And individually, I don't think you should just think about 1,000 yards either. The bar has to be set higher with this beginning.
Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game.
Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. On second down now, it's Harris. And he's got some space here. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
78 yards for him on the ground so far tonight, as he has been terrific in this first half.
Thought they were going to have him down a lot earlier, but he was able to shed that tackle.
Shows the value of the weight room, doesn't it? Shows the value of the attitude when you run the football. Don't go down easily. Break a few tackles, gain some additional yardage.
And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
That's an excellent play by the defender. He diagnosed that one, closed quickly, and helped force the incompletion.
To throw once more on second and 10. Jones, and this throw incomplete. And the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have him looking at third and 10. Looking to throw, Jones. This one to Bourne, and he's got it. And he will have a Patriots first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. They'll look to throw again. And an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number one. On second and 10, Jones into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 29, and he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at their 36-yard line.
Lawrence will throw. This one complete to Tonyan underneath.
And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number one.
Meanwhile, Lawrence's throw taken in by Chark.
Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10.
Here's Lawrence. This is Chenault on the receiving end.
And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25.
My goodness, they've come out locked in on this drive. Play calling, execution, they are fully in sync. Three straight passes, three first downs. They're moving the ball downfield almost.
Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 38.
It's the former Michigan man, Chase Winovich, who gets in there to bring him down.
So we've reached halftime with just the lone touchdown here. 7-0 is our score.
As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. We'll get back to you and Charles in a minute. But first, time to give the folks at home a look at what's going on around the NFL. We'll get started up at Paul Brown Stadium in Cincinnati, where it was the visiting Steelers who were able to walk away with the road victory. Kyle Trask leading the way in the victory with 3 touchdown passes. We'll stay in the AFC South as we head one state over to check on the Indianapolis Colts at home at Lucas Oil Stadium. And they were losers in that one as they fall to the visiting Tennessee Titans. Ryan Tannehill, excellent in the victory as his guys run their mark to 4-2 on the year. And lastly, we'll all be tuned in on Monday night for what should be a great one between the Las Vegas Raiders and the Denver Broncos. Meanwhile, in our game, just the lone touchdown accounting for all the scoring. A tight one, 7-0 is the score. And for the call of the second half, we send it back to our broadcast team of Brandon Gotten and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. So here we go for half number two. The Patriots with the lead, and they will be getting the football. This taken in at the goal line. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. So here are the Patriots to take over. They're on a 3-game winning streak and right now looking good in this one as well. Jones now on first down. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
To throw again on second down. Jones throwing middle, but it's incomplete. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a 3rd-and-10. Back to throw. Jones. He finds Aguilar over the middle. And he will have a Patriots first down as they're able to get the 3rd-down conversion.
Whenever we talk about moving the sticks and controlling the football, there's a great example right there. Those are the 3rd downs you need to convert to win football games. We're in the 3rd quarter of this one, and this is a tight one. In order to maintain pace, keep the ball away from the other team, and put points on the board, those are the plays they need to continue to convert.
I think that was good strategy there, trying to go right back to him after the last completion, but this time, the defense was all over him, and they got there to break that one up.
Throwing again on 2nd-and-10. Jones. Well, this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far and brings up 3rd down.
We've seen these defenses make enough opportunistic plays to keep this one low scoring. Flying around, making plays on the ball, and we see yet another errant throw as a result.
It's caught by Aguilar. And he will have a Patriots first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
Oh, that was a nice job there. Quarterback and receiver reading the pressure that was brought. They both knew it was going to open up the middle of the field. Nice little shake and bake in the line of scrimmage, got right into his route. And the quarterback hit him in stride, and he was able to run free after the catch. That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side, and all the way inside the 15 before they drop it.
It's taken a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
Touchdown, Patriots! Nelson Agholor! His third touchdown now on the year. And the Patriots take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead.
Circle that drive, because that might be one to remember. Well executed to give him a little cushion.
Well, let's take it into the boxing ring. You talk about them commanding it, keeping the fight where they wanted to, whether it was in the center of the ring or putting them on the ropes, because it was jab, jab, jab. And finally, the haymaker to put that drive away.
Extra point right down the middle, and it's now 14 to nothing. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
From the 10. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further, as he's dropped it to 23-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And their halftime hole now even deeper. And they need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger. But no time for discouragement. Just got to get back to it, right? Put your shoulder against the boulder and start pushing and try and get back to where you were to start the half.
60 Pittsburgh. Recon, 132 fighter.
On second down, it's Robinson.
And this will be a Jaguars first down as the tackle made just shy of the 40.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
They go play action with Lawrence.
Right side, it's the tight end, Hockenson. And he's out of bounds just before the midfield stripe at the 49.
They go play action now. Lawrence.
It's caught on the right side by Robinson. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10.
From the gun, it's Lawrence.
Out to the left there and complete to the tight end, Hockenson. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night.
You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. But to throw again is Lawrence. Going back to the same well, it's Hockenson again.
Well, correct me if I'm wrong, you know, you're down two scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full two-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call two plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
And down inside the 15, shy of the 10.
Good yardage on the completion there. And when they look at the scoreboard, they do understand a field goal is not going to do them any good. My guess, they're going to press the ball downfield as far as possible, try and throw it into the end zone and get a score, because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball back as quickly as possible.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game.
Robinson.
And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the two. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down.
I think this offense, specifically this running game, they're going to have to find a way to turn the page, because they haven't found a way to run it effectively thus far, and it's cost them.
Back at the two now. Here's second and goal.
Etienne.
And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. After getting stuffed on first down, not much better there. Two-yard gain. And the question now, can the Patriot defense hold firm again on third and goal? And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville.
James Robinson with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Jaguars are finally on the board here in the fourth quarter.
Myers connects on the PAT. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
Fielded just outside the goal line. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23.
Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. We'll get a report when we return to Foxborough.
New England with a first down as they begin the drive.
After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have three timeouts. So do you run the football here or do you throw it?
I think you have a full conversation with your offensive unit. And you tell them, here's the situation. They've got all of their timeouts, so we are not going to play this conservatively. We've got to attack them. We've got to make them use those, gain the ground that we need in order to put this game away. If you think we're just going to run it three times and punt it, you got another thing coming.
Yeah, and by the way, also the two-minute warning in play, so essentially four timeouts left.
They have to be aggressive here.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game.
So the Patriots with a football as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. And he's going to take this across midfield into Jacksonville territory. So fresh out of the two-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. Now this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. And now we're going to get a timeout defensively. So another stop, 1:50 left in the football game. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They hand this off to Harris. The Jaguars now will use the last of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Now it looks like he'll throw.
Picked off at the 38, and the Jags are right back in this football game.
A seismic shift in momentum here in the fourth quarter. That's the break that the defense needed.
And you know as well as I do, people are going to question the play call in that situation. Sometimes you have to question the execution, not necessarily the call. And in this case, those defenders found a way to give their team a chance.
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
They'll look to throw toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Shark calls it in and able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play.
Second and 21, a lot of ground to cover.
Back to throw. He's going to loft one deep over the middle.
Oh, and that nearly ended it. That should have been intercepted, but he cannot corral it. And that is a lifeline there with third down coming up.
Back to throw. Open man, it's Preston Williams. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots 28. Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still, you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
So for the Patriots, their strong start to the year continues as they're up to 5-1. And they will hit the road next week to take on the Miami Dolphins. Meanwhile, for Jacksonville, the loss here will move them back to 500 at 3-3. And they'll have a chance at redemption next week at home against the Indianapolis Colts. That'll do it for us. I'm Brandon Gauden alongside Charles Davis. Thanks to our entire crew as well. We'll talk to you next time. So long, everybody.
tonight. From Hard Rock Stadium in Miami, Florida, it's Week 7 of the NFL on EA Sports. We'll see Tua Tagovailoa and the Miami Dolphins taking on Mac Jones and the New England Patriots.
From beautiful South Florida, there's a look at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami. The excitement brewing here in South Florida. As a moment ago, the Dolphins starters were introduced to this home crowd. They're fired up as well as they get set to match up with the New England Patriots. Charles Davis. Charles, you look at the Dolphins as they enter play in this one. They come in playing pretty good football. Winners of four of their last six games. On the other side of the field for the visiting Patriots, they're in a real groove of late. Winners of five of their last six games.
And the way they played last week defensively, you look at the tape, it looks like they had extra guys on the field and they thoroughly shut down that offense.
Point of the NFL season. Week 7 is underway on EA Sports. Wishing he had a mulligan. That's not how you want to start the game.
Not at all, because not only do you give up the penalty and good field position, but it just kills the momentum of your team as you start a game.
First down, Tagovailoa, and his first look is incomplete.
After watching him drop that slant, I can hear my old coach's voice ringing in my ears right now. You can't run with the ball until you catch it. Trying to get those rack yards before he secured it.
Now an open man, that's the tight end Gesicki. It's complete, and he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Here's Tagovailoa on first and 10. Open man left side. It's a tight end long. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. This defense for the Patriots, they were very good in the win last week against Jacksonville.
And they needed to be because the game was a game we don't see very often anymore. Low scoring, slugging it out in the trenches. One play can make the difference type of a game, and each play took on more importance, and they got it done.
5 yards remain on second down. Now Tua. Throw left side complete. That's long. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots 33.
Well, it's just been an aerial attack all the way downfield, and they're putting it to the defense in a big way right now. What do you think, partner? Do you now run the football? Because they're in a pretty good spot already at the outer edges of the field goal.
But like you always tell me, you're still far enough away from the end zone that a pass could be a good option here, too.
That's into a crowd and intercepted. It's Kyler Duggar who picks it. And the Pats are going to take possession of the football as they force the turnover on the opening drive.
So here are the Patriots now backed up a bit to start their first drive.
They're led by their quarterback from the University of Alabama, Mac Jones.
And I thought in last week's game, he found a way to win like a good pitcher without his best stuff. I mean, he did throw two interceptions,
yeah,
offset by one touchdown pass. Not the ratio, not the numbers you're really looking for as a QB. But finding a way to win, that's all that really matters.
Throwing Jones. Nelson Aguilar, and he gets it to the 30 when it's all said and done.
And they were backed up to start the drive, but not anymore. Now that's the play call that the offensive coordinator had in his head. You saw the end result. He wanted to go ahead and push the ball downfield, and that's what they did, and they wound up with good yardage there to get things rolling.
A look at the numbers for Aguilar a week ago. 8 catches, 102 yards, and a touchdown.
And aren't we approaching the halfway point of the season? I mean, we're midway through this one, and we're seeing big numbers from him just about every week, and that's why he's leading the league. Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
To throw on second and 10, Jones. And he comes back with one complete. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins 40.
Really been an ideal start for them. They get the turnover on the opening possession. Now here they are moving the ball straight down the field on their first drive.
And that feels good, but you know on their side of the field, all they're thinking is finish this drive off because they took it away, right? So now you've got them back on their heels a little bit. Now go down, put a touchdown on them. Look out, you've won the mental battle early in the game, and that may carry over for you.
Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6. This is Harris. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line.
He was solid last week, over 100 yards in their victory on the ground. They want to get that going again.
Absolutely. What they also understand is that from week to week, it's not necessarily the same, but they want it to be, right? What they saw last week on the ground, they want to see in this game as well.
Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Jones on 1st and 10. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Picked off by Jerome Baker. And the Dolphins will take over here at their own 14-yard line. Well, a shaky start for both quarterbacks now. We had the interception on the opening drive, and now they throw it right back to him.
So does that mean we're really kind of starting from the beginning, Brandon, right? Both of them have done it, so we kind of start from scratch. Looks to me like both of these defenses have done their homework, and they're executing quite well.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. Now, they were intercepted the first time they had the football, but now they get it back, and it's still 0-0.
And because of that, you know what the thought process is? Interception. What interception? It didn't really happen because they gave up no points. So go back on the attack. Go back and run the offense you believe will be successful. Find your playmakers and give them the football.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. He'll get this to his tight end, Gesicki. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. Looking to pass. Tua got his man. It's the tight end long. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
And that's well executed there on 3rd down. And I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw. And they hooked up there for a 1st down.
He's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right at a yard. Nyheim Hines, his 1st carry. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35.
Sometimes those lines that are drawn on a grease board or in a playbook, they come to life out on the field, don't they? And we just saw down that outside handoff to the right.
That right tackle, he gets excited for that call, doesn't he?
He does, because he just wants to dominate his guy and say, listen, I was the point of attack. I took care of business. That's why you're able to get downfield and add all those yards to your total.
Yeah, really nice gain there. Tua now on 1st down. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6. A gain of 6 there on 1st. 2 minutes on the clock in what's been a scoreless 1st half. Looking to throw again on 2nd down. Tua got his man complete over the middle. That's Fuller.
I think that's a big pickup for a 1st down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a 1st down, executed it to perfection. From the 4, it's 2nd and a couple. Again, they will throw it with Tagovailoa. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And the Patriots are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. 2nd straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one? Or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
And he still has yet to get on track in this 1st half as they're going to stop him behind the line. After the loss to start out, here's 2nd and 11. On the give, this is Harris. And he'll go down at the 26 following a gain of 6. Once again, they'll keep it on the ground. And they'll indeed stop him on 3rd down. And now what do you want to do with your timeouts? Now the Dolphins going to burn the 1st of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the 1st half of play. A field goal gets them the lead, but they'll risk it here on 4th and goal. 4th down, here's Stidham looking for Aguilar, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 30, and they will take over at the 29-yard line.
You can easily see the logic. It's a tie game. They just wanted to press it a little bit right before the half, hoping to get one more score.
Yeah, easy to second guess the result, but now you have to think after that interception, just a field goal, and they're behind at the break.
Yeah, I think at the half, the head coach just says, look, that's on me. I wanted to press it, but it's because I believe in you guys.
To throw again on 2nd down. Tua over the middle and complete to Waddle. The Dolphins going to take their 2nd timeout as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the 1st half. Setting to throw on first down is Tua. The pass underneath. Here's Hines with it. Now the Dolphins will use the last of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. On second and very short, Tua to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Tua setting up shop to throw again. And that is caught. Touchdown, Miami. Mecole Hardman in the final seconds of the first half. And the Dolphins have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half. We don't see too many scoreless halves in football, not today's day and age, and we're not going to see one here. We finally have points on the board.
And it didn't come easy, did it? Because neither of these offenses really gotten out of the starting blocks yet. But that is definitely an important score right there. Who knows? The way their defense is played, that touchdown might even hold up until the end.
Extra point up and good by Sanders, and that makes the score 7-0. So just 8 ticks remaining here in the first half as they'll kick this one away from the 10. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And they'll have time for one play. That's it. 3 seconds to go before intermission. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked up by Xavier Howard. So the two teams will head to the locker rooms here in Miami with the Dolphins on top. As we send you up to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome in, everyone, to our EA Sports Halftime Report.
The second half upon us sooner than we bargained for. Week 7, second half. Let's do it. The Patriots trailing here, but they will have the football first as the third quarter is underway. And this will not be returned, so the second half begins with a touchback. Jarrett Stidham and the Pats set to take over. And he's had some time to chew on that interception he threw on his last drive back in the first half.
Well, normally we say, well, get him right back out on the field and play again, right? But as you mentioned, had the halftime, had to stew about it a little bit. Maybe he'll have a chance to relax a little, kind of laugh and chuckle and let it go.
He'll hope to respond positively here to start the third quarter. Stidham going to lead the Pats up first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They turn to Harris to begin the drive. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
Harris going to get it again on second down. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime means had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secure before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They run with Harris. And he's across the 43, extra yards to the 43. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3. A give to Harris. And tackled down after a gain of 3. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
Every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. They run with Harris. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. We'll get an update when we come back to Miami.
Second and 6. No, scratch that. Second and 7.
Now a give. Running left is Harris. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39.
56 yards rushing for him in the ball game now on 14 carries.
All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. They'll try the right side with Harris. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
And tough sledding. He'll get maybe a yard, stop short of the 35.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one to the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
Now Stidham. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10.
Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4.
I'll tell you what, this offense is playing a little bit of keep away right now. They've come out here in the third quarter, possessed the ball for quite a while, and they keep on converting. Nice pitch and catch there to set up the first and goal.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. One quarter remains here as we wrap up the week on a Monday night. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
And they'll run again.
And he's over the line and into the end zone for a Patriots score. Damian Harris, his 11th touchdown of the year.
And the Patriots are an extra point away from tying this game here in the fourth. We are set up for a fantastic finish now. A fourth quarter touchdown here. We're an extra point away from a tie football game.
And I know they're thinking about possibly going for two, but I'd go ahead and kick this one and just get it back to level.
And he's got it. So the two-point conversion is good, and they add on to their fourth quarter lead.
They didn't want the tie. They roll the dice, and they take the lead.
That felt like a tone setter, didn't it? Forget tying the ball game and feel like we're just hanging with you. We're going to go ahead and push it to a one-point lead, and it just changes the complexion of the whole game.
The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line.
First down Miami as they get set to start the drive.
And they will be looking to answer the touchdown their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one.
And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down.
This defense has certainly had an outstanding second half, haven't they? I know they just gave up a first down there, and for the offense, they're hoping that that's something that they can jumpstart with and maybe start to move the ball a little bit better. But it's been tough sledding for them here the entire second half.
And he'll be stopped right at midfield.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed, too.
And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. From the 41, Tua. Another catch there for Waddle. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots' 25-yard line.
This has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Under pressure, and he'll go down. Sacked back at the 31. He couldn't get rid of it. He takes a sack for a loss of 6 to bring up second down.
Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest ones, maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. They've got a third down, but they are in field goal range already. They run with Hines, and he's going to get this to about the 20, but that is well short of what he needed. Now, after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. We'll get an update when we come back to Hard Rock Stadium. Sanders' kick is good, and they have taken the lead here in the final 2 minutes. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well, and kudos to you. You didn't jinx it.
After the field goal, here comes Sanders to kick it away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he takes this near the 25, just a little pass there, caught it to 26. So here's Stidham and the Patriots. Down 10-8, a little under a minute 50 remaining. And their four-game winning streak in great danger. They'll start on the ground with Harris. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 78 yards rushing for him now as he's done it on 19 carries. This is Harris, and he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down. Second down and 8. Here's Harris. They follow up the gain of 2 with a gain of 1 that time. Bring on an extra defensive back on third down. Stidham. He's going to complete to Aguilar. And he will have a Patriots first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Well, they have had no answer for this connection all night long.
They just have to think in a 2-minute situation, that's got to be a concentration lapse. You know they're going to go back to him with the game that he's been having.
They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. And now with 4 seconds left, we get a timeout call. And now it all rests on the right foot of their kicker. And now with 4 seconds left, we get a timeout call. And now this game's going to come down to the right leg of their kicker. They'll spot it at the 40. It's a 50-yard kick for the win. And he got it. He splits the uprights from 50 yards out. And it'll be a good time in the back bay tonight. The Patriots have won the football game. So this will wind up a victory for the New England Patriots. And they were really helped by their defense, forcing 3 turnovers.
I think what we saw in this one, today's defense. And what I mean by that is in the old days, pitching shutouts was big time. That was paramount. But the big thing was holding people down, holding down their yardage, right? Don't let them throw the ball through the air and gain a lot of. But now, it's about taking the ball away, taking away possessions, getting the ball back for their offense. They had 3 takeaways in this one, and it led them to victory.
So for New England, They remain one of the hottest teams out there as the win moves them to 6-1.
And they will be at home for one next week against the Las Vegas Raiders.
Meanwhile, for the Dolphins, the loss drops them back to 4-3 so far. And they'll try to turn things around next week as they have a matchup in New Orleans against the Saints. I'm Brandon Gauden. Certainly have to thank Charles Davis, my broadcast partner, and our entire crew. We'll catch you next time right here. It's the NFL on EA Sports.